You get points based on how compliant you are being with the system, with the rules that are set. As I was explaining the other day, that when it comes to your carbon footprint and how they're gonna control you in that aspect, an example is that they themselves give, but they don't actually paint the full picture. They give you the brighter side of the picture, but they not show the dark side of it, right? Now, you as excuse me, how them gonna control your spending is by letting you know that, look, last week you bought a pair of shoes, you bought a backpack, and you bought some some process thing, and the amount of carbon that are the amount of carbon you added to the environment through this through all this spending, you're barred from buying these things until a certain time, right? Or you're just barred from spending overall until a certain time. See, that's what they're coming with, yo. See, them come with a system where you have to be compliant with, right? Your spending will be limited, which in other words, controlled. Just like how your movement was limited 2 years ago, right? That was all about control, yo. Cause when I really think about it, when I really look back on it, none. Of not nothing that was that they were saying made any sense, but because they had the people, the fear upon the people, everybody just complied. See, which that's not what we want to be in at the time when the true terrible thing comes in, right? The actual MOTBO, we can't get scared. Based off of what them a tell we say, based off of them threats that them a make, right? It's gonna be food are gonna be scarce, limited, whatever. So be it. Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai say I'm gonna feed him servants. I will believe that. You see me? Whatever it is that may happen, yo. We leave it all in the hands of Yahweh Shem Yahushai, because he promised us that with these things that are coming, he's gonna be there for us. See, so all we need to do is just practice patience, that is it. Right? Social credit, social compliance, right, as it pertains to your carbon footprint. In order for them to keep track of your carbon footprint, you will have zero privacy, right? Everything you do will be monitored. Just as I explained before, they're going to know what you're buying, what you're spending on, right? Regardless if you used two different credit cards on two different websites, it don't matter. Right, it doesn't even have to be a website, yo. You can be ordering a cup of coffee from Starbucks, right? They're going to factor in the emissions or the carbon that was emitted during the process of preparing the cup that your coffee will be served in, right? The process of preparing the coffee beans. Right, the process that the beans had to go through, the logistic process that the beans had to go through in order to get to your local Starbucks. See, that's as I say, that's just an example of the type of control we are forward. You see me? All right, it says everything you do will be monitored. You will have zero privacy. You will have also zero autonomy. You know, then we're gonna decide what you can do, what you can't do, what you can have, what you can own, what you can eat, where you can go. Right? And all of these things tie into one, right? The one world order. Seeing whether it's the CBDCs, the MOTB, right? I should say the CBDCs, which will lead straight to the MOTB, right? excuse me. Seeing all of these things that you see right here. Seeing? Right, all of this ultimately leads back to the New World Order, yo. All of these things are interconnected. Seeing? CBDCs, the wallets that are being pushed, climate change, carbon footprint, right? You name it, all of these things. Starlink, internet, free internet that is being pushed in a lot of places, you know, that is also a part of it, because you also have a thing called the Internet of Things, you know, wherein you're soon going to have a lot of smart technology around you, right? Smart cameras in the streets, smart poles, right? The light posts them, you know, smart street lamps. See, so all of these things, you know, once all of these things come into being, right? Oops. You're gonna have that's when you're gonna have totally have zero privacy. See me? Cause you will be monitored. Once you have that MOTB, the implantable microchip, you know, with the Internet of Things, where everything is basically smart, that's how you will be tracked. Not necessarily by one satellite picking you up from your exact location, right? But by you pinging, or your chip being pinged, right, through different devices. Get an understanding of how that works, of what I'm referring to, look for an explanation on how the Apple EarTags work. You know, look up some information on how the Apple EarTags works. As a matter of fact, specifically, you can watch a video that was done by that Indian guy that reviews technology. You know, a lot of people probably Mr. Who's the Boss, right? Mr. Who's the Boss. He did a breakdown, you know, and some tests on the AirTag that explained a lot. And it really makes sense when you really add that type of technology to the Internet of Things. You know, when I apply that to the Internet of Things plus the chip, you know, you see how easy it is for them to actually track you, you know. But it's been going on for a bit without reading, so I'm gonna read a few more precepts and then we can end it off right there. So the next precept I'm gonna read, Revelation, we all know most, is Revelation 13 and verse 15. It says, "And he hath power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed." Right? And when you go into that word worship, it's talking about literal worship, you know. It makes mention of a dog licking their master.